Prasad to escort CA Narasimhan sir onto the dais. Our third technical session is on Information Technology and ISCA by CA Narasimhan sir. CA Narasimhan sir is an independent information system assurance professional from Bangalore and a partner at Ken and Co. Chartered Accountants. Sir specializes in information technology consulting, information system assurance, data analytics, implementation and testing of internal financial controls, SOX and SOC, audits, and has dealt with clients ranging from startups to large corporates in the field of insurance, banking, software, airline, e-commerce, online retailers, government of foreign countries, and many other cross-functional organizations. Being a Corbett enthusiast, sir is an active user of Corbett for various engagements. Sir has cleared the CISA exam amongst the top 20% of world in ranking, and currently a coach, mentor, trainer, author of the same. Sir has presented papers in various seminars on information system audit, COBIT 5, Digital India, data analysis, cyber security to more than 5,000 members at various levels. He was the youngest speaker at the ISCA's Asia Pacific CACS 2017 at Dubai. With a round of applause, let's welcome CA Narasimhan sir.
Good afternoon to all of you. Better I always check the mic, because the first time I spoke one of the Sikasa events, you know, a few minutes I started speaking and none of them heard, and the technical person came and helped me out, and in the mic he looked at me and I said, sorry sir, speakers of Palooza. I didn't understand whom he was referring to, but be that as it may, you know, it's very crucial that we understand, you know, the technology before we get started, correct? So we live in a world which is surrounded by technology, literally everywhere, correct? Starting from the smallest moment where we, you know, from the stage of birth, there is some element of technology. Even for that so-called death today, there is an element of technology, you know. At the end of the day, earlier, we were born in a womb and ended in the tomb, correct? Today, our birth happens with technology and also the death happens with technology. In between is where we need to audit. And that is why we have to have the subject, okay? So most important reason, many of them keep on creeping, why do I have this subject? Sir, I am not a software engineer. Sir, if you are a software engineer, they will not keep the subject. They will give you C++ programming, etc, etc. What they want is, how do you audit this technology? I will just give you a small narrative before I get started. A typical filmy style, and this is how I start my session anywhere. If you have heard it, it's still okay. Listen it as well for the first time. So there were two fellows who were walking on the lane, a typical filmy style as I told you. You know, a boyfriend and a girlfriend, and a so-called villain comes opposite. Immediately he looks at them and he says that, you know, he bangs into them and, you know, there's a war of words and, you know, the war of hands, fight, all the crowd gathers, some of police come and the crowd gets dispersed. When this fight was happening, a mobile phone of the hero fell down. And this villain, so-called villain, no, he wanted to take revenge. He said, okay, let me do something. He took his mobile phone, he said, let me try to teach this fellow a lesson. For some reason, he tried to use that phone, somehow he was able to unlock. How he unlocked it later, I'll explain. He opened an app called XYZ Bank. That's not named it. He opened the bank, he wanted to check the balance. The moment you open an app with the bank, what does it say? Enter the password pin. He didn't know the pin. So immediately he thought for a while and he said that, okay, you know, let me think about it. He clicked forgot password. The most famous thing which we keep on doing, right? Typically after our examination is over, we go back to our office, we have forgotten so many things, correct? Forgot password is the first thing which we do. So we click the forgot password link, and in a few minutes it said, what is your mother's maiden name? He said, how do I know this? I have stolen the mobile from somebody, how do I know that person's name? He said, okay, fine. He was browsing through. There was a very famous app with the F symbol, Facebook. he and his mom had taken a selfie with one ice cream yesterday and he had tagged her, took the mother's name, entered it. Security question number one here. Question number two, what is your school's name? He tried the same strategy, but to his surprise, in Facebook, nothing about his school was mentioned. He was thinking aloud, then he realized that Facebook paid $17 billion to acquire a company, WhatsApp. Most of us have a group in WhatsApp called so-and-so school group. He went over there, clicked the school, took the name of the school and mentioned it over here. Security question number clear. And then they said, we have sent you a link to your registered email ID to reset your password. And where is that registered email ID? In the same mobile phone. He clicked the password and gave you a final question. We have sent you an OTP. Please enter the OTP to reset your password. And where does the OTP come? To the same mobile phone. Entered the mobile phone, he was able to do a transfer. My dear friends, two things which I want to drive away from here. First, the most dangerous device which we carry on this planet is within our pocket. You should know how to use that, especially during examinations. Second, we live in a world where we breathe, eat and sleep risk. In fact, there is a very famous saying by the Kaspersky founder. He mentions that there are only two types of people in this world. One set of people who know that they have been attacked, another set of people who don't know that they have been attacked. Everybody has to face that risk. And in that world, we as a profession will have to give an assurance that yes, everything is happening here is right. You go to a bank, there is not even a single person who does a manual process, except for to a limited extent of filling application forms. Everything is automated. And it is the same automated environment 12,000 crore rupees fraud is on. Correct? Which means, we live in an era, as much as all the 7 papers which is complimenting us, this is equally setting, because all those 7 papers, this is the lubricant which is driving us. Because earlier we had A form, today everything is E form. We need to know how the technology works, correct? So we know how the technology works, and that is why the importance, why this course has been brought into the syllabus. Quickly moving into what is a CA or ISCA to a CA student. This is a typical scenario where we have, correct? So we are a typical student like this, studying IPCC, information technology, correct? Or your CA final or ISCA, correct? So that's the era where we are. Very, very tough and very, very challenging. And fortunately or unfortunately, this is one of the last papers. Why one of the last papers? In your CA final, of course, you have IDT and DT. But if you look into your inter, which is your CA for intermediate or IPCC, this happens to be one of the last papers, and already by that time your mind is gone. You know, your mind has already become blank and you're already frustrated, and the frustration comes out in the results. Right? So that is where we are actually sitting up. So to quickly, you know, talk about how technology is evolved, I want to emphasize and make a mention that why this is necessary. Why this is necessary. And then I will draw into the subject a quick snapshot to understand that. Do we all agree on this?
Yes, sir.
Isn't this the reality? In fact, the reality is that this device is going to be replaced by this. It's already in the process. Correct? I have seen clients who literally do their accounting in their mobile phones. It is still okay for a few days when I don't carry my laptop, I'm still able to do most of my work on my mobile. Because that is where technology is headed into. Which means, as a professional who embraces technology, we should know how to audit it. That is the core essence. That is a very crucial part of it, and that is why we will quickly move on. First, a few general tips. This is applicable for IPCC as well as CA final. Okay? It is a neutral, it is applicable for both of them. Before that, if I just want to understand the demographic, how many of them are in CA final old syllabus? A good number, okay? IPCC, IPCC I think is the old syllabus, right? New is called intermediate. IPCC, how many of them are in IPCC? A good number. And how many of them are in intermediate? Okay, a fairly mixed proportion. So I'm presuming there are some people who are in the CA final new syllabus. For you folks, this is not applicable because it's not there in the syllabus. For whatever reason, I'm not going to discuss that. The first and foremost which you need to understand, the entire paper what you read is split into two. One is your technical concepts. Every chapter there is an element of technical concepts. Every chapter. Okay? Or there are some chapters which focus only on the technical concepts. Some of them will be very, very general in nature. Now, where it is a technical concept, you need to spend a little extra time. For example, cloud computing, it's a technical concept. For example, you know, the way the network structure works. I'm sure you have read that bus topology, ring topology, star. These are all technical. You need to spend a little extra time. On the other hand, you have general gap. For instance, BCP, business continuity planning. Or, you know, evolution of technology. Where, how chartered accountants have to embrace technology. Where all can I use technology? So those are generalistic in nature. It is left up to you how you want to rephrase those components. So few basic steps. A chain is as strong as its weakest link. Fortunately or unfortunately, in the entire CA curriculum, this paper turns out to be the weakest link. I'm sure you have had your experience in the past, or perhaps professional experience of your friends, which indicate that this is one paper where they are getting stuck. I think most of them, correct? I would say 90% of the people, one, because they have not understood how to adapt to that paper. The strategy which you use for those 6 papers or 7 papers cannot be used for this, because it is a technical paper. We need to understand it. It is a technical paper. So that means you need to change the strategy. I'm sure I'm trying to help you out in that particular part of it. Second, do not panic. It is an extended form of common sense. Every topic which you read, you will see it in and around. Cloud accounting, concept of cloud. Sir, we deal with it day in and day out. Gmail is a classical example of a cloud. You know, we follow the SaaS model. Then we have something called as IaaS, PaaS. You know, so many types of that. The conceptual clarity, you please relate it with the example. In fact, when I take classes, I always make a mention in the left hand side of the book, always write the practical examples which you have come across. And then read the right hand side, you will never forget it. If you are going to a shopping mall, see how the technology is being used. If you are going to a friend's, you know, if you are going to a movie, how it is used. In fact, every movie I see, I perceive what is the technology within it. For instance, there is this wonderful movie called Robo, you know, which came up with a lot of technological elements, correct? So I relate each and everything over there. One robo creating so many other robos, that is called a worm attack. That is called as a worm attack, which is there in your syllabus. Correct? One robo trying to remove the problem in another robo, called debugging, removing the problem. So try to relate in and out what you see, you will surely remember this subject. My dear friends, that's a pro tip which I would be telling. Next, being in IT era, you should invariably pass. It's not that those topics what you read, in fact one of the questions in ITC examination, short note question was, explain in brief what is WhatsApp. 2 marks question. Those are in ITC, 2 marks, 2 examples. Our students got so very happy that, you know, something which is very, very fond of them, they have come in the exam. They wrote everything, whatever they have come across, every possible thing, which they were doing with WhatsApp. The institute does not expect it. At the end of the day, what is WhatsApp? It is a communication tool. The word communication is important in your answer. WhatsApp is a communication tool or a software, correct? Which can work on multiple platforms. That is crucial. It works on iOS. It works on your Android. It works on what is called Windows, Nokia, Symbian to some extent. These are the words which they are looking at. What did our students write? In fact, last part I will discuss. I have taken the screenshots of students' answer papers. How I got it, that's another part of the story. I have taken the answer paper screenshots. They have to explain what has gone wrong. And I think that will help you out in a much, much more clear manner. Correct? So you need to use those technical words. That is very crucial. Being the last subject, don't think too much about what to do about exams. I think sir was complimenting about it, correct? You know, sir was making a mention of it that, you know, do not think too many things what I have to do after the exam. It is still okay. Be very, very focused because this is the last mile. Remember, in the examination, normally the last 3-4 exams, you find it very, very difficult because your body is already lost on the steam. You need to reinforce. You need to bring that together. Dot diagrams are very, 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 very important. Please draw diagrams, and diagrams literally need not be like the ones which are given here. Just for information, none of these diagrams I did it. I used the artificial intelligence technique and it is automatically giving me these results. Just to say that I am adopting technology. I am a chartered accountant. day in and day out I use technology, and I don't require expensive software for this. Alright, coming back. So draw a diagram so that you are able to explain. For instance, if they ask you about a concept called LAN, WAN, MAN, if they ask you a concept called star, bus, ring, mesh, please draw the diagrams. Please understand, the person who is evaluating a paper, he has already seen so many same answers. If he sees something little unique and different, it will add a lot of value to you. Next, students will have to answer two papers separately within 3 hours. This is applicable only for intermediate students, not just for final. Alright, because you have your intermediate, you have EIS plus SM or IT plus SM, depending on what scheme you fall under. They will give you 3 hours. They will give you 3 hours. They will give you both the question papers and both the answer slips. It is up to you how you want to use those 3 hours. I have seen some students making a strategy, first I'll write IT. Some students say I'll make first SM. It is up to you, but ensure you write both. It shouldn't be like the Mr. Bean series, which you have seen, if you recollect. You know, there were two papers of trigonometry and mathematics and you used only one in last minute release. Do not do that. Please understand there is ample time. Have a watch over time. Correct? That's exactly what I wanted to mention. Have a watch over time. Now, very important thing is, sir, how do I plan the timing in exam? Very simple. Don't sit and calculate all these things, sir. Simple rule of thumb. First one hour, compulsory 30 marks you should finish. Second 1 hour, you should have completed 65 marks. 65 marks. The balance 1 hour, obviously you have to complete the rest. Correct? First 1 hour is 30 because our handwriting is very beautiful in the first 1 hour. Second 1 hour, we only will make it difficult to understand. Third 1 hour, nobody will understand. Correct? So that is why we keep on saying best should always come in the first. Best should always come in the first. So ensure that you have a watch over time. A few other basic steps which you have to follow. For each chapter, understand the purpose. Now, how do I understand this? Most of us, what we do when we have to start, we directly take the book or you know the chapter and start going to it and start reading 10 times, 15 times, 20 times, 25 times, but I forgot obviously. We don't understand what is the purpose. Just before the content, there is one half a page or a 2-page write-up for all the 8 chapters or 6 chapters as the case may be. I think IPCC is 5 chapters, CFL is 8 chapters. Each of the topic that is given a purpose, read 2 or 3 lines. Then think, based on this as a chart of content, what am I going to do? For example, there is a chapter called Protection of Information Assets. Correct? A very, very important chapter in CFL. In fact, it is there in your CA intermediate also, in the new syllabus. Correct? Now, you need to understand how that risk is going to impact me. That means in an exam, they will ask you, if this is the risk, as an auditor, how will you verify? If this is the risk, as an auditor, how will you check it? Correct? And one more beauty about redesign, in fact, I think sir was mentioning, there's a concept called out of syllabus question, right? In this, they cannot ask you anything out of syllabus. In any other paper, they can ask you any other topic outside, meaning concept will be the same. They will ask you with changing numbers, changing concepts. In this paper, nothing can they can ask out of the syllabus. First, they should know something to ask out of the syllabus. But anyways, keep that aside. More importantly, they cannot go outside that, so it becomes all the more easier. It's just one guided material. Try to relate the topic with your practical inferences, experience, what you come across, that will be very handy. Yeah, this is one very specific strategy which I would mention. After you read every chapter, please prepare a small gist. A gist could be a topic specific. How do you know how to prepare it? If you see the study material, it always begins with 1.1, 1.2, 1.3, 1.4. 2.1 like this. So every 1.1, that should be a small gist. If you read that, it is like, you know, zooming the map of your Google Maps, came up with so much of technology where we can identify anything in that map. But what is the first thing we identify? Where our house is. Typical, that's what we do, right? So the same structure, we zoom so much, we are able to get it. And that's essentially what I'm telling you. Your entire syllabus, you should do a typical concept called as a mind mapping. Okay, 8 chapters speak about these things. Double click one of the chapters. This chapter has these topics. Double click one of this topic, there is a core essence, that's it. If you are able to prepare, and it becomes all the more easier when you have prepared a summary. Alright? And one more tip which I would suggest is, many of them have this habit that we will read Infotech continuously for 4 days, 5 days. It's come for 4 days, 5 days. And they make a typical plan in such a way, first 4 days, you know, first 8 days I study this paper, 8 days, 8 days, 8 days, 8 days. And last 8 days we are allotted for ISKCON information. Our history of performance of reading clearly indicates that if I allot 8 days, I will study for 9 days. First 9 days are rules, second 9 days law. Like that I kept on studying. In that span of 80 days, I had to study 10 days for 8 subjects. Whereas what I did was, I studied 11 days for each of the subjects. So 11 into 7, 77 days I have already spent, and 3 days only is available for my subject. I hope now you understood why students find this as a challenge. Therefore, I would request you to reinvent the strategy. Way back in school, we used to do read every subject every 1 hour. Correct? I am not asking you to do that. 2-3 days you study one subject. Okay, stop it. Then move on to the next subject. This way, you will have a mix and match first. Boredom will not leave you. Second, and third, when you read the second time, you will be able to recollect what you have read the previous time. Many students ask, sir, if I do this strategy, I will not be able to remember anything before the exam. Or, you know, I am not able to remember anything. Only if I continue to study at a stretch, I am able to remember. My dear friends, that is wrong. If you continue at a stretch, you remember for only for the next 2 days and forgot it. If you do this way, you are periodically, frequently reading. Another possible strategy which you can try, read this subject every day 2 hours. Irrespective of what happens, this time of the day, I will read this compulsory. I will not do anything else. You know, plan a strategy like that, morning, evening, again I will leave to you because you are the best judge of it. Write and practice keywords and bullet points. You need to write and practice them. In fact, I will show you in one of the examination how the institute expects the answers and what the student is written. Now coming to certain special strategies when you are answering this paper. After preparation of one chapter, I think I made a reference, try to quickly glance through and see what are the areas you are able to remember, not able to remember. Mark them with all those stick notes, important, etc. etc. I have literally seen some students who have cleared their exam, they came back and told, I casually asked them, sir, please give me your notes so that I can learn from you. I asked my students, please teach me because I can learn from them. When I saw their book, literally every page or almost every topic, they put a stick note, a marker, paintbrush, whatever possible tool they used it. But they said they were able to capture things much more effectively. Read the glossary, pro tip. After the end of the study material, you have a glossary which we don't even touch. My dear friends, those are the 2 marks and the 4 mark questions, especially EIS and Infotech. When I discuss the question paper pattern, you will realize there are a lot of 2 mark questions. To give you an actual, you know, instance, 6 plus 5, 11 2 mark questions are asked in the entire EIS and Infotech paper. As far as CA final is concerned, they ask you 4 mark questions. Again, the same problem. Same scenario. The only reason is because this guy is double that of your Infotech marks. Read the heading. This is another pro tip. This one of my students came and told me, sir, I did one simple tip. I figured out wherever 4 or 5 bullet points were there in the material. I used to remember the sentence before that 4 or 5 bullet points. That was exactly an examination question. Instead of 4 marks questions, 8 mark questions, correct? 8 mark questions, the expectation is right about 8 points, 4 mark questions around 3 to 4 points. That's the general expectation. Anywhere in your study material you see 3 to 4 questions or in 3 to 4 sub points, read the sentence prior to that. That is your examination question. Okay, so that becomes a pro tip another. Always remember to read a topic with 4 to 8 bullet points. So what if it has more than 8 to 10 bullet points? Restrict yourself only to 8 to 10 bullet points or, you know, maximum of 10. Some topic you will find 25-30 points. Remember only 10, enough. Sir, why only 10? Marks required is around 8. Right? Remember 10 points. Because in examination, you have to keep a provision for bad dates. 2 marks, you know, 2 points, you invariably forget it. Correct? So reserve for bad dates we need to keep. So therefore, you try to remember 10 or 12 and all of them should be unique. Please keep that in mind. Sometimes you find many points are correlated. Try to remember unique points. Give the heading for all the bullet points as per ICA exam. This one more student came up and said, sir, only if you mug up this paper you can answer. My dear friends, the answer is no. The institute's expectation is you should give the same at least header. Meaning every point when you are answering, you should never answer in a paragraph approach. Never ever answer in a paragraph approach. It should always be bullet. And don't even do numbering. 1, 2, 3, 4. Why tell me? If you do 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 mark question, you have written only 3 points. That fellow clearly knows you have written 3 points. On the other end, if it's a 4 mark question, and you have written bullet 1, bullet 2, bullet 3, third is actually the fourth point is continuing. Four and instead of giving you four, he might probably give three, or instead of giving 3.5, he might not 2.5, 3.5. That 1 mark matters. In this paper, every mark matters. Considering, you know, the trend or the observations which you have generally known. Correct? So give headings for all the bullet points and try to reproduce the headings as given by the ICA material. Explanation, logically you can do it. Answer only in bullet points, no serial number also, I think I mentioned about it. And whenever you have to remember, try to make what is called a mnemonic form. I think it will come in a little later. Yeah. No? Mnemonic form. What is a mnemonic form? Shortcut. For example, what are the types of application controls? I use this concept called bicycle iPod. BIC, boundary controls, input controls, communication controls. BIC. POD, processing controls, output controls, database controls. Correct? So like this, so many things you can make a mnemonic form. And that way you can easily remember, but don't make too many mnemonic forms. You'll require a mnemonic form to remember the mnemonic. Alright, so have a limitation everywhere. But generally, I would suggest you making this. Yeah, this is one more pro tip which I have seen. When they ask you, explain the features of this. First, explain the paragraph. What is that? Then explain the features. Meaning, every answer you write, there will be at least 4 to 5 lines which will explain what it is. Once that explanation is given, then you speak about bullet point number 1, bullet point number 2, bullet point number 3. Am I making sense? Yeah? Next. Sorry. After reading every subtopic, prepare rough questions which could possibly be identified. And prepare a summary of the list of topics after every chapter. Just for information, something like this. Something like this. So what happens? This is there in your EIS new syllabus. It is there in the EIS new syllabus, which is, I think, intermediate, right? Intermediate is called EIS, Enterprise Information System. In a new syllabus, what they did, they give in the beginning of the chapter. My suggestion is read at the end of the chapter. So you can literally map, okay. And this is what is called mind mapping technique. I map each of them. You know, this topic, this is how I try to relate it. Typically, in your accounting also, we follow this. This is called as balance sheet or, you know, financials. Under financials, there are four things. Asset, liability, income, expense. Correct? Under assets, you have current assets, non-current assets. Under liabilities, you have shareholder, correct? That way we are trying to map it. Go from the top, come to the bottom. Now, a very important thing. Order of preparation. Most of the students feel very happy studying the first chapter. Very good, sir. In CA final, if you study the first chapter, I am sure you will not touch the remaining 7 chapters. Not that the institute has not applied a logic in keeping it. They have kept a logic. But from a student-friendly perspective, I have redefined. I did a lot of research for information before this. I was also into the same stream. I was also a student. You know, I'll just probably give you a small minute of how I came into this profession. The earlier speaker, C.H. Chandrasekhar Shetty, who was my faculty, he told that after you finish your CA final, immediately you should do take up this course called BISA. I casually took it up and went and told him, sir, I finished this course called BISA. He said, congratulations, please start teaching information technology. I didn't know whether I should be happy or sad. Happy that I'm getting an opportunity to share my thoughts. But somewhere a fear that I have to teach a subject which is so dreadful. You know, with students, any student, if you ask anything casually, sir, IT, no. ISKA, over, no. Correct, that is where we are unfortunate. That's where I took it as a challenge. I started reading, specializing so much into this that government of foreign companies have called me to invite and make a speak. You know, in front of their community, correct? So I read so much, I gave my 100% to it. It is possible if you just push in your 100%, alright? Keep that in mind. So what is the order of preparation? First, I will be speaking on EIS, which is the new syllabus. My suggestion is, my dear friends, please start with chapter number 3. This is only for new syllabus EIS. I will speak about all the topics. Start with chapter number 3. Why? Lot of concepts have been given over here. Lot of concepts. And in fact, so many things about technology, and this is the biggest chapter in your entire syllabus. Those of you have gone through the EIS syllabus and content, correct? Next, go through financial accounting and then move into automated business process, then move into core banking and e-commerce and m-commerce. So that is the recommended structure. This PPT will be available. I'll ask the institute to post it on the website also, so anybody wants, you can take it, alright? Marks weightage, new syllabus is one more tip which you have, especially CA final and CIPCC new syllabus. They have already given what is the weightage expected from each chapter. But fortunately, unfortunately, slightly. For EIS, they have given an equal weightage, 15 to 25%. That means on average 7 to 13 marks you can expect in each chapter. Every chapter is important. Imagine that every chapter in your syllabus is each part of your body. You go to a doctor, you say, I have a neck pain, or I have a general physician, not the specialist. I have a general physician, you know, you go to a general physician, you say, I have a neck pain or stomach pain, he will diagnose. He will never say, sir, this part I didn't study in my syllabus. He will always say that, okay, there might be an advanced problem, you may have to go here. At least that much he knows. He never says, oh, sorry, I don't deal with it. Correct? So, which means you should be aware of each and every part. Correct? Now, coming to IT. When you come to IT, this is CA IPCC old syllabus. Again, I would suggest chapter number 3 because technical, telecommunication network, huge amount of technical content is there. Huge amount of technical content. Okay, so I would sincerely request you to spend time here. And then move on to business information system, a very, very, very simple chapter. Extremely, you remember I told you initially, technical, gyan. This is all the gyan related. This is all the technical related. Alright? Next, business process automation, and then move on to 4 and 5. This is absolutely fine. You might be wondering why fundamentals you are reading in the last. I totally understand. It is against the way in which the institute is given the presentation or the syllabus. But I have found many students having success with this. In fact, when you read 1, 2, 3, 4 and then come to this chapter number 2, it becomes a refresher for you. It becomes a quick revision for you. So that's the reason I came up with this strategy. And my past experience is that, again, every chapter 10 to 12 marks. One or two cases they have actually had, you know, plus minus. But generally, which I have seen in, you know, IT also, some cases I have seen, every chapter they compulsory ask you 12 marks. Because 12 into 5 is 60, because your marks is for 60. Okay? ISKA. CA final. The big daddy of all daddies. Correct? You know, the most challenging thing. My humble request is, please read information system concepts first. Information system concepts first. So, that is just chapter number 2. Immediately after that, go to this SDLC, which is now also called as Acquisition Development Lifecycle, and then move on to business continuity and spend a good amount of time in production of information assets. Okay, for those of you who feel that you're not able to take it down, you can probably use a photo or, you know, one of those. In case that is also not working, anyways, it will be hosted on the institute website. Auditing, concept of governance, this is where many of the students have found it challenging. That is the first chapter. First chapter. In fact, I have recommended you to take it up a little later. Okay? And then information technology, regulatory issues, and last is your emerging technologies. Again, trends have proven that each and every chapter has got good amount of weightage, not equal weightage, good weightage. Generally, this your acquisition has a good weightage, which is chapter number 5. Protection of information, excellent chapter for institute examination asking questions. Auditing off late has become very important. Regulatory issue, there are 3 topics in the end, you know, where they speak about RBI rules, SEBI rules, and IRDA rules. Every exam, at least one of those have been asked. And don't think that it was asked in the previous exam, they'll not ask it this time. There are 2-3 exams where they ask the same question 2 times back to back. Okay, moral of the story, not only history, even ISKA repeats. Alright, and last is emerging technologies. This is another area compulsory, you can expect minimum 2-3 questions. Especially on the cloud accounting concepts, web 3.0, you know, social media, you know, various things on that, emerging technologies. And likewise, it is also there in your EIS syllabus. So now we have got a clarity on what is the order. Reference material. Which material should I refer? Sir, I have taken every examination I have attempted, I have taken one different material. No. Big mistake. Do not go outside this beautiful book. ICI study material is there. I have seen many people, with due respect my dear friends, there are excellent authors in this, I know that. But they have not, the students have not got marks. With due respect to everybody, with, you know, not that, you know, I am biased, etc. I feel the institute study material is sufficient. Once you are done with the institute study material, please go through the practice manual. Practice manual is more like a revision. It is applicable only for CA final, it is applicable only for IPCC. Intermediate, I don't think it is, as of now, available. Probably in a few days time it might still come. Suggested answers by ICAI, highly recommended, minimum 2 suggested answers you should read. Minimum 2 suggested answers. And last is your RTP, revision test paper. Okay, revision test paper. And sometimes the institute also comes up with this mock examination, right? So it is recommended that you take it. Sometimes RTP you might find it slightly standard and a different approach. Don't break your head. Stick on to the fundamentals. Nothing outside your material will come into the exam. Now comes the most important thing, examination pattern. How should I structure this? If you look into EIS and IT, it's a 50 marks paper. The questions they will ask you is for 60. EIS only one, you know, what do you call, examination is completed until now. IT of course multiple examinations. Your first question is always a compulsory question and it is a short note question. When I say short note question, you are expected to write a minimum of 4 to 5 points over there for each and every topic. It could be differentiate, it could be explain in brief, it could be what is the meaning of so and so. So they can ask you concepts over here. This is where the glossary is very important. Next, question number 2 to 6, 5 questions, 8 marks. Sub questions are maybe 4 marks, 1 or 2 cases I have seen 6 plus 2 marks also. I hope you are getting what I am trying to say. So question number 2 to 6, what happens? 8 marks each. Sub questions have 4 marks normally, but sometimes it could also be 1 8 mark per question or it could also be 6 plus 2. And a pro tip over here is, flowchart is one of the most commonly asked one question over here. And flowchart is not complicated, it's just logic which you have taught. Okay, so it's a very simple topic and you will find this easy to attack. Are you clear? And then comes last, 7th question is normally coming with an internal choice. And this internal choice is 10 marks, 5 questions into 2, of which you need to answer only 4. So if you logically understand this, question number 1 compulsory I need to write. From question number 2 to 7, that is 6 questions, I need to answer only 5. I repeat my statement. Question number 1 is compulsory. Question number 2 to 6 is, you know, I mean 2 to 7, that is totally 6 questions, only 5 you need to write. Now this is where your planning can come into picture. Generally the 7th question comes with an internal choice. Some exams instead of 7, it could be 6 questions, don't bother about the number. The fact that you have an internal choice. My suggestion and experience of my students have been that, please attempt question number 1 because you don't have an option. Please attempt question number 7 or 6 because there is an internal choice. Remaining, you choose what you can apply. And all this decision you have to do during the 15 minutes gap which they give you reading time. Please spend some time. Are you clear on this? So that is where you can try to save a good amount of things. Quickly coming to ISKA. Question number 1 is normally a practical question. They give you a case study sort of a thing, but the concept is what they are trying to test you. Okay? And one more risk which I would like to tell you, your question number 1, if you don't attempt, there is a possible risk that your syllabus will be computed only to the extent of 80% of the marks. Or your marks, whatever you get, 80% only may be given. There is a possible risk. Nobody has proven facts. So my suggestion is please attempt question number 1. But need not be in the first instance. You can attempt it little later also, but make it a point that you attempt. Clear? Again, coming back to ISKA, question number 2 to 6, just the same thing what you found there, double of that, correct? 16 marks, sub questions are 4 to 6, and the last question normally has an internal choice. Again, it makes sense to attempt here. So it's totally double of what you solve. How a few practical questions appear, you know, just to give an example. So they give you a case, Bharat Bank is having so and so. They try to give some information. Based on the case itself, you will understand what are they trying to test you. You know, from each chapter generally they ask you, and they ask you what is the strategy, what are the IT tools, what is the suggested control, what is BCM. This was on May 2016. Now for want of time, I just picked up one of the questions where I had analyzed it wrong. Okay, a few important areas. I will just run through this because for want of time, in which case it will be available in the website. So if you are looking into IT old syllabus, again, this is what I told you, remember the fundamental chart, technical concepts, general gear, split it, especially technical concepts, chapter 2 and 3, huge technical concepts are there, old syllabus, whereas if you look into management gear, you will find chapter number 1 is pure gear, what is strategy, what is you know business process re-engineering, so many things are there in the chapter number 1, IT old syllabus, you know few things. Flowchart is a very, very, very crucial thing in this chapter. Please expect questions on flowchart. Compulsory, generally there is a print has been there. They could ask you 1, 2 mark or 4 mark question based on process flow, computing technology, computing technologies when it comes to chapter number 2. Chapter 3 has got multiple definitions and could be asked for 2 marks questions. For example, difference between switch and a router, very very popular question. There are 6 technical concepts there: network connecting devices, terminals, switch, router, hub. Correct? There are a lot of things on that. Please ensure technically you are very sound. Okay, there are a few videos of mine available on YouTube. You can probably look into that. I'll give you my YouTube channel as well, where I've clarified all of these and made it very easy. And I have a few online courses also. In case you are interested, you can probably look into it. Telecommunication networking model, WAN, MAN, correct? All of those comes in chapter 3. Network topology, security protocol. Generally, one question is asked: HTTPS, SSL, SSH. All these are few technical things. Types of e-commerce, and generally we are aware of this. Chapter number 4, EIS, MIS, Digital Support Systems, correct? Meaning and scope of business process re-engineering, emerging technologies, compulsory question in all the 3, whether it is EIS, whether it is IT, or whether it is ISTA. Please expect questions on IaaS, PaaS and SaaS, grid computing, network virtualization. It is a common topic across all the 3 syllabus. When I say all the 3, I am referring to IPCC, Intermediate and CFM. Suggested to read the glossary, I think you've spoken about it. EIS, new syllabus, a few topics. Again, I have necessary bifurcation. IT technical concepts, chapter 3, heavy on technology. Chapter 4 also has got some technology. What is artificial intelligence? You know, what is cloud computing? What is virtualization? All those are covered in chapter number 4. New syllabus. Okay? Then process and accounting related, chapter number 1, 2 and 5. In fact, for those of you who are answering this EIS, one very important, I think it will be covered in the next part, as Ron mentioned there. Chapter number 2, general gyan, story reading, especially they ask you what are being a master, lecture, etc. So chapter number 1, this risk and controls, which you see in chapter number 1, is repeated in chapter number 4 as well as chapter number 5. Chapter 4 talks about e-commerce and related. Chapter 5 talks about your core banking system. I am talking about EIS, new syllabus. Wherever you find risk and control, it is an important area. Because as an auditor, you should know what is the risk involved in every process. Equally, you should know what is the control. Especially chapter number 1, they speak about what is a sales cycle risk, what is procurement cycle risk, what is a HR cycle risk. Most of the time, the risks tend to be same, customized for that particular thing. So those of you writing EIS, that you can make use of it. Chapter 2, the concept of how audit of ERP system integration, that's a crucial thing. And last, there's a very interesting topic called analytics and business intelligence, an important area. Chapter 3 is where the most technical part of it is constrained. Okay, I would say that chapter is important. There are a lot of technical questions there. And chapter 4, e-commerce, which most of us day in and day out you know it, so you'll be easily able to relate it. And cloud computing, IaaS, PaaS, I think we spoke about it. Chapter 5, few risks relating to IT and banking and IT environment in CBS. These are few things. And last is your risks associated with specific processes. Credit card operation, what is the risk? Nirav Modi operation, what is the risk? Put it other way around, what is called as a bank guarantee, off the records, or what is that called? We call it as out of the balance sheet items, correct? Off balance sheet items. So what are the risks involved, guarantees, etc. So like that, there are so many items which cover it. Coming to ISCA, important areas. Again here, technical concepts, chapter 5, chapter 8, fully technological driven. Whereas your chapter 4 is general knowledge which you will be able to write. Combination could be chapter 2, some bit of technology, some bit of general gap. Correct? So I have a host of things, I will not spend too much time here because I am giving you this presentation. Please look it up from the website, I am sure you will make the arrangement for it. I think this is a general stuff which I have mentioned. Yeah, chapter 8 is very crucial in CA final, ISCA. Now comes the pro tip. Answering strategies. Sir, we have done enough of preparation for the war. It is like Bahubali movie. We have known that how the strategy is, etc., etc. But how do you attack the opponent? Opponent here is not nobody else, but the way you answer the examination. Could be our mind or it could be the way we present it. Answer the question which you know the first. Generally, history, geography, civics, mathematics, everything, all subjects, whatever you put in, generally, third and fourth question are the easiest. I repeat it, third and fourth question are the easiest. In fact, if you find it so very confusing, close your eyes, turn the question paper and directly read the second question or third question. There have been instances where the moment you see the first question, already panic sweating. Correct? So from top to bottom, everything is filled with water. So much of sweat, full panic. Correct? So relax, nothing goes wrong. Read the question paper properly, especially in ISKA. There are some cases where the same topic is covered twice. Understand the intention of the question, what you have to answer will be wonderful. For example, in ISKA, if you talk about, as an auditor, they are talking about chapter number 6. If they are talking about management or controls, they are talking about chapter number 3, protection of information assets. Understand that very clearly. If they are asking you as an auditor, it will always be driven from chapter number 6. Audit trails, how do you recover, how do you speak about, all of them comes in chapter 6. Next, give headings for all bullet points, and as much as possible, please try to reproduce the same thing which is given in the institute material. I think I have made a mention of it. Leave sufficient space between every sub-question. I have seen, in fact, I was in tears after looking at the question answer sheets. Student has written an answer, brilliant. Exact the wordings, you know, whatever technical words are necessary is written. But she did not leave space between the previous sub-question and the next sub-question. The second sub-question was not valued at all. It was a 4-marker question. Had she got 2 marks, 38 marks of hers would have become 40. Entire 6 months gone in vain, and she cleared every paper. Unfortunately, she was between the 50 to 60 range, not even exemption. All the 8 papers she had to write only because of this one. Please ensure you give sufficient space. It is okay. Green paper, I will not use paper, all those things you keep it aside. First you pass the exam, then you do all those activism, everything. Humble request. Please write answers separately. In fact, this point is very, very crucial. Whenever you begin your answer, please write the heading in the middle of the page. Answer to question number 1, answer to question number 2A, answer to question number 3A. Please write in the middle of the page. Do not write anything in the serial number, whatever that index column. No, it's okay even if you don't write it, please write the heading there. And if you have spent maybe about 2 or 3 lines of a page, you can write it. Otherwise, please write a fresh page, absolutely fine. You can just write PTO or, you know, refer the next step. Common mistakes made in exams. Short note questions, 2 marks. This will also be replicable for 4 mark questions. A simple question they ask. Differentiate between data and information. This I have taken exactly from the institute material, and I have taken the institute answers. I mean, institute answers is what you will find here. Data is raw and organized. If you have written that word, they look for marks. They give you marks. That needs to be processed. That means it is not a process. The fact that you are mentioning it is not process means that you have understood what is the meaning of data. It is an input for a process that creates an output. For example, look at this. They have given examples wherever possible. Example, number of statements, or, you know, can be in the form of a statement such as date, measurement, etc. Now look at the next. Information. When data is processed, organized, structured, or presented, they are looking at those 4 words. If you have written those 4 words, my dear friends, is it difficult to write this? It is only the wordings which we use. I will show you what is the word our students have used. And look at the way they have answered. First they have spoken about data, then they have spoken about information. And this was what? A 2-marker question. This is what other students used. They explained what is the meaning of data. Explain what is the meaning of information. Again came to data, again went to information, again came to data, again came to information. She has written, she or he has written a brilliant answer. I am not going to evaluate that thing, but I am only trying to tell what are the mistakes they made. What is the issue? How much marks given? One. Sir, this is live answer script. Live means previous examination or whatever. Correct? Why? All differences are clubbed and no separation is found. Just look at another student, what that person did. What did they do? Split it into 2. Data separately, information separately. I don't want you to take through this. I am looking at more at the presentation level. I hope you are with me. Look at the marks which she has got. Or she or he, I am not sure. Handwriting looks like whatever. That is not judged yet. But yeah. That is not judged yet. But look at the marks. 2-marker question, 1.5 you get, it is a good sir. Don't take tension. Don't take tension. Okay? So it is always good. That means, what is a good thing here? They differentiated. You may always say, sir, the institute did not differentiate, why should I differentiate? My dear friends, you put it the answer in a different way, you get more marks. Because you are somebody who is unique. That's what Robert Frost said. Take the path which nobody has taken, road not taken. Correct? Coming back. Next, differentiate between online processing and real-time processing. Two simple concepts. They explain what is online, they explain processing, what is here. Again here, I would not agree with the institute's presentation this way, because it's a suggested answer. It is not the actual answer. Remember, institute is what? Suggested answer, not the actual. So it is okay. These are not reasonably well, sir, or mentioning, right? So reasonably, this could be the answer. But on a reality, I would suggest write online processing, explain what is the meaning, write 2 or 3 bullet points. Real-time processing, whenever there is a differentiate between the following, I would suggest follow this approach. In fact, we suggest 3 columns. Nature of difference, feature of this, feature of this. That is the best presentation. Sir, I don't know what to do. Follow this. This also I don't know what to do. Follow this. Explain data, explain information. Absolutely fine. Absolutely fine. Okay? So that's basically on, you know, look at this again. They have spoken about few things, correct? Marks is unfortunately awarded a 0. She has actually spoken the right thing. Marks is given a 0. You know why? Is this question number 1C or 1E? Look at the way the student has written. In the dynamic moment, it will not flash all these things. My dear friends, small things matter the most. Remember, the more cool you are during an examination, the better you can perform. Every cricket player, every athlete, you know, India recently won so many medals in this Indonesia Asian Olympics. Every athlete maintained their calm and coolness. 1 second panic, that is where the entire thing goes for a toss. If you panic, nothing is going to happen. See, they have written everything is correct, but the student got 0. Why? Whether it's 1E or 1C, that one will not understand. And he need not answer you. Whoever is correcting it. Correct? So that is why he said, do lot of punya in life. You never know all these things. You know, that's why I think sir used to always tell us when we were students, donate blood. You never know how that will impact you coming back in the form of Mars. It is coming back on the lighter note. Correct? So again, this is, they have differentiated, but what has happened? They have given us 0. It looks like a bullseye. An omelette or whatever, but still, because there is no conceptual clarity. This is also to say, just because you have written a format like this, marks will not be given. Content should be there. Content should be there. That is very crucial. Okay, again, risks relating to mobile computing. Look at this. There are 4 words which they are looking at. Student has written all the 4 and given marks. 2 marks. Just to prove the fact that you will still get 2 out of 2. I mean, for the question. For the question, you will still get the full mark. Which means 100 out of 100 is possible in ISCA, not possible in AIS. Paper is only for 50 marks. Correct? So it is possible for you to score the entire thing. Sir, can I score it? No. Think that I will score it. 3 or 4 times back, I think one of the students got 97 in ISCA. Devru. Mark 20 wrote. just kidding, but yeah. So major concerns, correct? So again here they are not spoken about it, so you get the wrong mark. Now quickly moving on to, I think terminals, I think there is one more question. Now they are not given the conceptual clarity because the marks are not there, alright? So I will quickly move on to, yeah, look at this, keywords not mentioned. Terminals are starting and end point, correct? So those are the words which we are looking at. I will not spend too much time into this. 4 mark questions. Applicable for CA final, applicable for ISCA, or you know, whatever, all the things. Differentiate between centralized and decentralized. I have used only certain set of questions, but the principles, mistakes, what people make is common, correct? So again, they have used these words. You can follow the approach where you can see they have spoken about 1, 2, again, they have spoken about general, correct? So they have mixed and matched. So they have given only 2 marks out of 4 marks, correct? So probably they could have split it better. And here, what is mentioned, what is meaning of intrusion detection system? Pure technical question. Pure technical question. The answer, they obviously expect technical words. Student, if they have written any random thing, you know, it is also a cause of. Next, what an enterprise has to do in an appropriate manner, you know, for DBMS. Few basic things which have to explain. Again, the student has written all story, 0 marks. Why? No conceptual clarity again there, correct? What is Android? very, very famous, you know, before WhatsApp, this was a very famous question. Android is an operating system, all stories they've written. They're looking at these 4 or 5 words. Linux-based operating system is the word they're looking at. It is a smartphone, develop and create mobile applications. It's an open source, very, very crucial point. Android is an open source, that's a crucial word which they're looking at. It has a wide range of useful libraries, etc. Correct? So again, incorrect answer, I'm not going to 8 marks question. Especially 4 chart, applicable for IPCC and intermediate, not there in CFM. They asked one question like this, I think this was November 2017, okay? They asked one question like this. In fact, they have given you an answer. Generally, they give flowchart, no? So on the company does this. Here they have directly told, step number 1, step number 2, step number 3, step number 1, step number 2. And second part of the flowchart, they have asked you to give an answer for certain things. Look at this, L1 is equal to L2, print, L is equal to L plus 1, stop, go to L. Is it complicated? No. But in examination or full tension. When I practice in information technology, teacher told, print should come in the last. Yes or no? Print is always last, sir, because the problems you practice something like that, sir. What did our student do? Wrote everything, last wrote print. You tell whatever you want, I will follow my approach only. No, sir, you will not work. That is where the problem is. Look at the marks, sir. Moral of the story, flowchart, you get marks for the steps. Moral of the story, flowchart. This is also to say every subject they give you marks for the steps and working notes. Correct? But overall they basically lost out. One more beautiful thing, yeah. Follow the sequence. Print should come in the first. One more beautiful flowchart. Somewhere one job it got interconnected to somebody else. Sir, in case you have made a mistake, nothing wrong, sir. Strike it out. Please write, please ignore or something. Go to the next one. Absolutely fine. The reason why is because of this. They only don't know what they've written. Eggs, shapes, everything. And practice flowchart, not on the exam hall. Much before. Hey, what is that in flowchart? You write in exam, you get through. Most area where students make so many. Sir, 8 marks easily you can get, sir. You have to prepare only for 32 marks, sir. I'm sorry, 42 marks. Alright? So, flow the sequence in the examination. Okay, they have also given some interesting questions, but I will not spend too much time here. So my concluding remarks is this. Change in approach is the need of the hour. To audit technology, you cannot use fundamental approaches. To answer the 7 papers, you might use some strategies. Excellent. You may probably not be successful if you use it the same way. Correct? All that you wanted to know is you should know where the button to switch that off us. You would be able to do it. Moral of the story, what I have done in this last 1 hour is to give you where the button is. Where you have to use it is left to your choice. It is like, a teacher, if you go back to the good old school days, or the Vedanta, all these Pandavas were given so many weapons. It's not that any weapon I can use anytime. Each weapon has to use in a particular time. I have given you the weapons. The way you use it is totally yours. On that note, a chain is as strong as the weakest link. Don't let ISCA or EIS or IT be your biggest link. Life is much beyond EIS, IT and ISCA. Keep calm, CA is not a stop. On that note, get set, do well in exams, before that ensure you have your lunch now. Thank you Bangalore branch, thank you Srinivas sir for giving this opportunity. I hope I was able to decode, give it a gist and try to keep it very crisp and what is necessary. My email ID is available there. I am generally available on Facebook, social media. Narasimhan Ilangovan is my full name on social media. YouTube channel is Narasimhan Ilangovan. You can probably search, you will get this. Few of my videos on these concepts I have explained. I am also a DSA faculty because I have been able to digest these concepts, and the institute also gave me an opportunity. I also go across the place to explain these things. So make use of technology. In case you are having any issues, feel free to reach out. All of my online classes, everything are available online. You can probably reach out. On that note, thank you so much, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for the informative session and compressing the GBs of data into KB. I now request the member of SICASA, Suresh, to present sir with a memento as a token of gratitude. Session, we have always come across this one advice: have lunch on time. Abiding by the same, it's time for lunch break. You have sharply, I think not even 30 minutes, you have just 24 minutes. Please be back on time, okay? At 2:30 you have to be back. Thank you. And if you have not received your lunch coupons or forgotten your lunch coupons, reach out to Manjula ma'am.